A linear circuit made of two or more elements is also called voltage divider. A very simple voltage divider consists of two constant ohmic resistors. Here you can see a linear circuit of a 2.7 kΩ and a 56 ohm resistor connected to a 12 volt lead acid battery. The voltage drop at a single resistor is a fraction of the total voltage and the current running through the circuit is 4.4 mA. We can detect a voltage drop of 11.82 volts at R1 and 0.78 volts at R2. What is happening if the battery voltage will rise? The end of charge voltage of 12 volt lead acid batteries is 14 volts and you should stop uncharging them when the output voltage decreased to 11.2 volts. With the battery voltage, the voltage drop at R2 will rise between 0.87 and 0.72 volts. A voltage divider can be built by using more than just two resistors. If an output voltage of 0.75 volts at an input voltage of 12 volts is required, while the total resistance of the network should be 528 ohm, a 33 and a 495 ohm resistor should do the job, but you won't be able to purchase a 495 ohm resistor. The solution of the problem is to use one 470, one 15 and one 10 ohm resistor instead. You won't be able to purchase a 25 ohm resistor too. The measured voltage drop at R4 is 0.8 volts. The tolerance of the used resistors is plus minus 5%, by what the resulting voltage at R4 is between 0.68 and 0.82 volts. Furthermore, the output voltage of the used battery is slightly above the assumed 12 volts. Considering the tolerance, the output voltage of the two dividers is identical. At the video about electronical switches you can see that a base voltage of more than 0.75 volt is sufficient to turn on an electric motor by a bipolar junction transistor. After attaching the base pin of the transistor to the right voltage divider with a total resistance of 2880 ohm, the output voltage decreases below 0.7 volts and the motor doesn't turn. However, if the base is connected to the left voltage divider with a total resistance of just 528 ohm, the output voltage decreases slightly to 0.73 volts and the motor starts turning. But keep the poor efficiency of the low resistance voltage divider in mind. As you can see, a current of 24 mA is running through the circuit, while just 0.88 mA are drawn from the transistor. In principle, a potentiometer is an adjustable voltage divider. The voltage output at the sliding contact is between 0 volts and the input voltage of the divider. Usually they are constructed with a resistive element formed into an arc of a circle, a little less than a full turn. High power potentiometers are often made of wound resistance wire. A piece of resistance wire with a clamp used as sliding contact can be used as a very simple construction of a linear potentiometer. The output voltage of the divider can be used as input value of a control circuit, hence potentiometers can operate as sensors for positioning purposes. Servos usually use single turn potentiometers to control rotational movement. When shortening the middle pin connected internally to the sliding contact and one of the outer pins, a potentiometer turns into an adjustable resistor. Alternatively, you can connect the middle pin and just one of the outer pins to the circuit. This might be useful if a slightly varying output voltage is required for a special application. A bias voltage of 0.75 volts at an input voltage of 12 volts can be easily adjusted with a 1 kΩ and a 10 kΩ potentiometer, respectively a 100 kΩ resistor. The 10 kΩ potentiometer can be used for the rough adjustment and the 1 kΩ potentiometer for the fine tuning. An H-bridge is an electronic circuit that enables a voltage to be applied across a load in either direction. A very simple H-bridge consists of two voltage dividers. Here, two potentiometers are used with the load connected at the two sliding contacts. If the voltage output of potentiometer number 1 equals those of potentiometer number 2, e.g. both are at their middle position, no voltage is applied to the load. If the output voltage of the right potentiometer is adjusted to a lower value, the positive terminal is at the left side of the load. However, if the output voltage of the left potentiometer is adjusted to a lower value, the positive terminal is at the right side of the load. Like explained at the video about semiconductor diodes, the current voltage characteristic of a semiconductor diode differs from those of an ohmic resistor. The resistance of a forward biased silicon diode is decreasing significantly above a voltage drop of approximately 0.6 volts. When replacing R2 by a forward biased diode, the voltage drop doesn't exceed 0.6 volts, even if the input voltage is clearly higher. While doubling the input voltage from 12 to 24 volts, the output voltage increases just slightly, from 0.62 to 0.65 volts. By switching two or more forward biased diodes in series, the voltage drop is a multiple of 0.6. The resulting voltage drop is approximately 1.8 volts when using three diodes, both at 12 volts and 24 volts input voltage. A special kind of diode is the Zener diode. While used in forward polarity, the characteristics are identical to those of a normal diode. However, a Zener diode also allows a current to flow while it is reverse biased and the voltage is above a certain value known as the breakdown voltage or Zener voltage. The voltage drop at the 3.0 V Zener diode doesn't exceed those values clearly while it is reverse biased, hence the total current running through the voltage divider is affected by the resistance of R1 at input voltages above 3 volts. When connecting a load in parallel to the Zener diode, almost no voltage shift can be observed, as long as the resistance value of the load doesn't fall below a certain value. The LED can be operated with an input voltage of 12 or 24 volts without getting damaged or a large fluctuation in luminosity. A voltage divider made of a constant resistor and a Zener diode is therefore ideal for generating a reference voltage or as a voltage stabilizer for low current applications. The resistance of some devices varies significantly with temperature or light. A voltage divider with one constant and one variable resistor can be used as sensor. The voltage drop at the variable resistor varies with the physical quantity to be observed. Here, a phototransistor and a constant resistor are used to convert varying light intensity into a varying voltage drop. While the phototransistor gets illuminated, the voltage drop at those devices is decreasing. NTC means negative temperature coefficient. The resistance of those devices decreases significantly with increasing temperature. An NTC resistor can operate as temperature sensor. As you can see, the voltage drop decreases with increasing temperature. That's all about the usage of voltage dividers for today. Thanks for watching and bye for now.